Hi, my name is Sophia.
And I'm Chloe.
And we're sixth graders in Mrs. Mendy's class.
Hi, my name is Cameron.
And my name is Jackson.
And we're sixth graders in Mrs. Moreno's class.
We're going to be your tour guides through Walnut Elementary.
Let's start off in the office, and we can meet our principals and the staff. Come on, follow me.
Welcome to Walnut. Hello, we hope you enjoy our presentation.
Welcome to our virtual open house. Our students and staff have worked very hard this year, and I'm thrilled to be able to showcase them today.
Enjoy. Hello, Walnut families, welcome. We're so happy to have you join us virtually as we showcase the talent, the hard work of our students this year. They have worked extremely hard despite all the challenges and obstacles and hurdles that might have been placed in front of them. Our students have been so awesome. They've just gone along for the ride, and we're just so happy to showcase for you the hard work of our students and our community. We really hope you enjoy, and it brings a smile to your face as you visit our campus.
Sports class.
We have fun at school because we are learning about eggs. This is a chicken egg. Do the eggs hatch at the same time? They hatch after 21 days.
This is an incubator, and it has eggs inside.
We laid in a line and put them in.
Welcome to Mrs. Amra's class.
Welcome to D4, y'all!
Yeehaw. Exciting friends?
I feel like I'm in a different place, like I'm in Texas. Or
I know.
Or welcome to the farm. The farm? Yes.
Okay, go ahead, Ezra.
Down on the farm, where does the cow stay? Down on the farm.
up and share some facts with you?
Yes.
Did you know when baby ducks hatch, the mommy duck or daddy duck leads them to the water? Did you know that most ducks do not quack?
Did you know that pigs are the cleanest animals in the farm?
Did you know that hens run 9 miles per hour?
Did you know sheep eat grains?
Did you know that ducks are semi-aquatic?
Did you know sheep give us wool?
Did you know all ducks have webbed feet?
Did you know ducks have special oil?
Did you know baby horses are called the colts?
Thanks for coming by.
Welcome to G3.
This is my teacher, Mrs. Diaz.
Ferreira, we're going to
going to draw some names?
We're going to draw some
All
names.
All right, let's do it.
Here we go.
Oh, I get to draw? Oh.
You get to draw, this sure. Bucket.
All right, congratulations, friends. Friends, continue to show those good character traits.
Give a big round of applause to all of our recipients.
My first graders and I are excited to be with you here today on this Monday morning. We have some expectations that we'd like to go over quickly. Saeb is reminding you that you need to be active.
Listen. Hats and hoods off, white hand over your heart, ready soon.
To thrive, I came to win, to survive, to prosper, to rise, to blood, to blood. Yo.
Academics, fun, and exciting activities we have here.
Welcome to Mrs. Phillips' room.
Okay, here we go, Brooklyn. Okay, I'm just passing out the plans. Brooklyn, Mia,
coming out. There's a stick coming out.
What's it?
Yeah.
That's
so cool.
What's it? Mine has a leaf.
Is this a song?
Yeah!
Do you want us to sing
our
song?
Okay. Did you ever see a reader? A reader, a reader. Did you ever see a reader? A reader like me. Does it look like? Does it sound like? Does it make sense? What do you think? Did you ever see a reader? A reader like me.
Welcome to Miss Thomas's class. Come on in.
Are you growing a hair?
Yeah.
It's adorable. What are you called? People who grow plants?
A botanist.
So, Miss Alvarez put in some food coloring, and in the other one, she put in some watercolor, and she put in some two flowers and one flower in each one. And the flower is drinking the water and turning the flower the color. We predicted of which one we thought was gonna turn the flower color.
Watercolor or?
Food coloring.
And then the next day, what do you do?
the next day, we predicted everyone's going to be darker today.
Uh-huh. And then when on Monday, what are we going to do?
We're going to flip-flop.
And see if it... Go ahead.
And we're going to see if it's going to turn, like, both of the colors. Like, mixed.
Yes, exactly. I got it. So, what's this center do?
This one, this center does computers.
Computer center.
Yep.
Well, and the center?
We're writing about
Ryan.
And this must be the art center.
Yeah. We're coloring eggs to make that bunny over there.
Welcome to Mrs. Coffin's first grade class.
Students here, it looks like bunnies. Did you grow that grass?
Yeah.
What is that cute little creature?
A bunny.
Well, you all have cute little bunnies. Does your bunny have a name?
Yes.
What?
Rosie.
I knew you would have a name. Well, see, your cute little bunny. Does yours have a name?
Yeah.
Did you learn all about growing something?
Yes.
What
yes.
did you grow?
Grass.
Wow, it's so green and lush. Wow. I love it. Your bunnies are amazing. You could sell all that grass sod for people. Grow beautiful lawns. Wow.
All the way even with the edge of the cup, parallel with the cup.
That's amazing.
Makerspace and art studio.
What are you making?
What are we making?
A butterfly.
Wow.
What is the water doing to the markers?
Making it water paint.
Expanding. Good job in making it look like watercolors.
Welcome to Mrs. Young's room.
Today, guys, we're going to be doing the variant O. Remember, the variant O says, ah. Everybody say, ah.
Ah.
Thanks. All right. Here we go. So this is a?
Saw.
Saw. Everybody say,
saw.
Ah. Ah. Hold it. Saw. Good job. Sound?
Ah.
Hold it.
Ah.
Sound? What is he pointing to? How many sounds are in that word? Now, how many letters? How many sounds?
Hi, this is Miss Ferreira. She's our school counselor.
Let's see if she's in.
Hi, hello. Friends.
Can we take a look at you?
Hi, absolutely. Come on in. Welcome.
Hi, my name is Mrs. Fur, and I'm the school counselor at Walnut Elementary. I support all students at Walnut in the areas of social, emotional, and college and career awareness so that they can be successful in their academic learning. I help students develop skills and strategies to be better problem solvers, discover their abilities, which is something I like to refer to as their greatness, to build better relationships, and be their best selves.
Hard for me all day. How do they feel, my ambassadors of Walnut?
Dang, these are comfy.
They are really comfy.
Yeah.
Okay, get back to work.
Where's second grade math science?
We're gonna have to look for them.
We've made cheetahs, elephants, and rhinos, and zebras, and giraffes. So these are your animals that we did, and some of them are like meerkats, leopards, giraffes, and flamingos. And we wrote a story on it, and Miss Swartz stapled it for us.
The book that we're making is
just like these, but we did different pictures, and that the story is the same, but Miss Ferreira is going to publish it, and the book is about the African savanna, the African animals.
And you'll all get a copy just like these, all hardbound, beautifully illustrated with your own work. Yeah.
And it's, and it might look like this a little bit.
Okay. Let me turn this way and you can open it up and let me see it.
And this is what we're going to be doing, like this. How it, like how Elsa did the meerkats and they did the meerkats too, but it will look like this when we're done.
They all picked different animals too. Nobody did the same.
And you'll have be able to read all your work forever.
Yeah.
Awesome. Well, thank you, second grade.
Welcome to Mrs. Grisha's second grade rainforest.
I really am in the rainforest. Aren't I? Wow. Oh, what are you reading about?
I'm reading about the rainforest babies.
What are you reading about?
Rainforest crocodiles.
I didn't know there were crocodiles in the rainforest. I learn a lot. What are you reading about?
Rainforest ecstasy. I'm reading about frogs.
What are you reading about?
Rainforest babies. I'm reading about rainforest birds. Extreme rainforest.
Oh, what's an extreme rainforest? What's in there? Oh, is that a snake? Oh, that's my kind of book.
It may be.
Oh, yeah, I guess.
Ooh, nice.
What are you guys reading?
I'm reading In the Rainforest. I'm reading Rainforest Secrets.
This is second grade, Mrs. Avila's class.
Welcome to our ocean habitat!
I feel wet. It's so oceany in here. Wow.
Okay, go ahead, bye.
In my opinion, the ocean is a cool place because it has lots of sort of place, like a mako shark or a sea turtle.
My opinion is that I like the ocean because there's lots of cool colors and types of plants inside of the ocean.
In my opinion, the ocean is the best habitat ever. Dolphins can stay half awake and half asleep, and they're more enough awake to keep themselves from drowning, and they can watch so predators don't eat them.
Did you know green sea turtles are the largest species of hard-shelled sea turtle? Did you know orcas are at the top of the food chain and they have no predators?
Did you know that sea stars have one eye spot at the end of each arm?
Did you know male seahorses have a pouch to carry the baby's eggs?
This is our swarm of jellyfish.
This is our swarm of jellyfish.
Did you know that jellyfish have no brains or bones?
Did you know that actually sea turtles eat jellyfish?
Did you know some different jellyfish are different colors? Some are clear and some are like bright colors.
Did you know a different type of jellyfish, like a moon galley?
Stay underwater for 10 minutes by slowing down its heart rate.
Humans eat jellyfish.
Did you know that hammerhead sharks eat fish, stingrays, and other sharks?
Did you know that blobfishes can be 12 inches in length and 20 pounds of weight?
Did you know that sharks eat stingray?
Did you know moon jellies live in the sunlight and the twilight zone?
Did you know the blue whale is the biggest animal, even bigger than the dinosaurs?
Did you know that the Great Barrier Reef is 1,429 miles long?
A little pop-out thing.
They look lovely. Hello? 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 Anyone there? I just wanted to say you're all doing an amazing job.
Welcome to Mrs. Hale's class. I'm going to show you some of the stuff that we do in class. First, let's see the biographies.
Okay, biography group.
Hi, this is all our biographies. And I was Dolly Parton. I write lots of songs, too, like Jolene and The Coat of Many Colors. My mom made me a coat of many colors, and I loved it.
Baby, I'm just gonna shake. Shake it off,
Ladies and gentlemen, Taylor Swift! Woo! Out here at
Okay, let's go see the camera group.
Oh, okay, you scroll up. The title of your story is
The Little Mermaids.
We've been working on a fairy tale called Princess and the Prince.
And you're collaborating on the story together, huh?
That looks awesome.
This is what it looks like.
Can you read us a little piece of it?
Yeah.
Once upon a time, there was a queen and a king that had a beautiful baby named Isabella. One day, Isabella's mother...
Okay, we're going to go to the last group, the robot group.
Can you try this?
That's pretty good. How long did it take you to figure that out?
A couple of days, but it was worth it.
Welcome to our room.
This is Mrs. Bergendahl's class.
Hello, Mrs. Bergendahl's class. What are you going to show me today?
Our eggs.
So we put our eggs in vinegar and then we let them sit for a day. And this is one of them.
Oh, I wonder what happens to eggs when you put them in vinegar. What happens?
They cracked a little bit and they got bubbles all over them.
Pick it up. Where are you? Where's your first one to
stay?
Whoa. Be careful.
Okay,
it looks like a
jelly.
It feels like jelly. It feels like jelly.
Try to bounce it.
Don't bounce.
I just said it was bouncing.
It feels super squeezy.
It's like slimy.
It feels squeezy, like a squeezy ball.
It's heavy.
And it's heavy.
I want to just throw it. It squeezes. I wonder if we...
Like it feels like it's bouncy.
Yeah.
It feels like it's bouncy.
It feels
very squishy.
It feels,
really squishy.
It feels like a squishy bouncy ball.
Yeah, it's like a bouncy ball.
Squishy,
squishy.
Okay.
Oh,
no.
Oh, that was bouncy.
Okay,
so we built a walker bot with all the options right here. We decided to use the walker bot.
Is it like a real engineer, huh?
Uh-huh, and this is what the robot bot will look like when it's all finished.
Oh, by robot bot, is it going to go on water?
Yes, it's made on water.
Can I see the picture at the front of the book?
The front of the book is
that's the walker bot.
How is it powered?
So it's covered by solar power.
And then the solar power is going through these wires into the body, and the body has all the gears that makes it work to make it move properly. But if something is in the way.
Hello. This is Vanderbilt's class, and we're in the library.
The librarian is Miss Tracy.
Miss Tracy, you're a librarian?
Yeah.
Let's go meet them.
Miss Tracy and...
So what do you like about the library? What do you read?
Diary of a Wimpy Kid, The Meltdown.
Oh. Are you a fan?
Yes, I like Diary of a Wimpy Kid.
I'm reading Allergic.
What are you reading?
Nancy Drew.
Hello everybody, my name's Mason and I'm in the Science Olympiad, so let's go inside and see what everybody's doing. So over here, they are doing straw egg drop. This is Mrs. Vanderveen, coach of the Walnut Science Olympiad team. And she is a very good coach. As you can see, she has coached us through all of these trophies, through the third places, second places, a lot of second places, and then even got a first place one time.
Wow. We have 18 children up here and 17 different science events. These are fourth, fifth, and sixth graders from the math science, and they have worked very hard and studied very long, right?
Hi, my name is Marissa, and I am the PTO president here at Walnut Elementary. I am a mom of two kids. My oldest, Ava, is in third grade, and my youngest, Wyatt, is a kinder here also. This is our PTO office. It is crazy full of carnival stuff right now. The carnival is the biggest event that we hold for our families to come out and enjoy together. It helps strengthen our Walnut community while also raising necessary funds needed for our classrooms and staff. The PTO's goal is to volunteer and raise funds necessary to help our school. These funds are used to purchase items like musical instruments or classroom supplies, paintbrushes, paint. So we also fund things like class study trips, as well as your classroom electives, your school electives, and extracurricular activities as well. By the way, I'm looking forward to seeing you at the carnival this Saturday.
Pancake robot, come and get them all their hot.
The pancake robot is coming to town. He's mixing up the batter and he's laying it down. Buttermilk, blueberry, chocolate chip. 50 million pancakes, he's gonna flip. All you can eat, yum yum. All you can eat, yum yum. The pancake robot is coming to town. All you can eat, yum yum. All you can eat, yum yum. It's a pancake explosion, come and party down.
Pancake robot, come and get up.
Pancake robot's in town.
Welcome to Mrs. Russell's class. Come on, we have something to show you.
Okay, I'm gonna pan the room. Everybody can wave.
These are our rainbow trout. And they started off as eggs, and then
they turned into alevin.
Something that's special about alevin is that they have a special egg sac that will feed them until they need food. They're going to the Don Pedro Reservoir where we will do a release.
To let them go?
Yeah.
Yeah.
Oh.
I say bon voyage.
Well, let's all get you waving goodbye to the fish.
Bye.
Bye. Bye.
Welcome to Ms. Kiraka's class.
This class knows what to do to succeed.
What do you do to succeed?
Whatever it takes!
I was born to burn, I was born for this. Whip, whip, run me like a racehorse. Pull me like a ripcord. Break me down and build me up. I wanna be the slip, slip. Word upon your lip, lip. Rather that you rip, rip. Break me down and build me up. Whatever it takes.
Mrs. Norwich class, come on and see our missions.
Hi. Hello, Mrs. Norwich class.
Hello.
mission is that?
It's mission San Juan Bautista.
Okay, what's your mission?
My mission is San Luis Obispo, and it's made out of styrofoam.
My mission is San Carlos Borromeo de Carmelo.
Ooh, you said that so well. Let's hear that again.
My mission is San Carlos Borromeo de Carmelo.
My mission is Mission San Jose, made out of styrofoam.
Wow. These are amazing.
My mission is Mission Santa Cruz.
Tilt the torso a little bit to get the reflection. That's awesome.
My mission is Mission Santa Cruz.
My mission is Mission Santa Cruz.
These are our portraits and writing.
Awesome. What incredible pictures. Point to you. Which one are you? Oh, the one that says Barbara.
Hello. My name is King George III. I am the leader of the British Empire.
I feel that the colonies England has set up are under my control.
My name is George Washington. I am known for many things. Farmer, surveyor, and commander-in-chief of the Continental Army.
After the war, I will become the first elected president of the United States of America.
First in battle, first in peace, and first in the hearts of my countrymen.
The Americans dare to demand certain freedoms, but I will not hear of it.
March!
March! Welcome to Mrs. Lee's room. Y'all come on in.
Welcome to Mr. Chisnewski's 5th grade class.
Wow!
Don't they look amazing?
They do! Where are you going in that wagon?
Let's.
Which is all used for different things.
Yeah, then we got Drew and Aiden right over here.
Welcome to Mrs. Torres' classroom. Come on in and look around.
Hello.
Like kind of like how we made a mushroom, because these are some decomposers.
A project about why do plants need vitamins. And we're supposed to make a trifold. And we're almost done with it.
Yeah, so Jonah did all of this side, all the decorations, and then I was drawing our little example, and then we were just working and finishing it up.
This is a prototype that they've already built, and they're going to use this to test out the negative effects, and then they build their final build, and we'll test those and see if they've been able to engineer something really strong. So it's a really fun and exciting unit, and they just love the hands-on learning that they're getting to do with this.
So these are the 3D printers. So they make 3D models of things that you make in this program called Tinkercad. So Tinkercad, you use shapes and make them together into cool things. This one, I'm not sure what it's printing, but it uses a type of plastic, which is this, and layers it down in like the shape of what you're trying to print. And you can see it work, try to get a close up. You can see like it like placing plastic down.
Class.
Thank you.
Wake up.
We don't want to wake up. We're tired from Olympics.
Olympics will now take place.